second speaker is Derek Mackay, MSP, MSP for Renfrewshire North and West. Derek needs no real introduction to the town's community. He's an enthusiastic supporter of Scotland's towns and Scotland's places. At the conference last year, we built the SDP conference around the six themes from the Fraser Review, and Derek launched the government's response to the Town Centre Action Plan. At that conference, I extracted a promise. I hesitate to call it a vow. I extracted a promise to come to Paisley 1 year on and say how things are going. He's done this and he's done more. The debate in Parliament fairly recently on Town Centre Action Plan 1 year on, the government alignment behind towns, the Town Centre First Agreement with COSLA, and championing the various demonstration projects. So I'll now hand over to, amongst other things, the Towns Minister, Derek Mackay. Please join me in welcoming him to the SDP.
Thank you very much, Lee, for that very welcome and warm introduction. Not only did I keep the vow, I went further. I think there's a great message in that, especially in this significant week and this significant day where there will be a new First Minister of Scotland about to select her ministers. It was in that parliamentary debate, I was heralding the positives of having a dedicated minister for towns. And the Deputy First Minister, as she was at the time, said under her breath, but just loud enough for me to hear when I said, it's not etiquette to pitch for a job in a cabinet reshuffle. And she said, you're damn right it's not, Derek. You might have a lot of time in your hands after this week. So I have enjoyed being the dedicated minister for towns as part of my local government and planning portfolio. So it's great to have so many of you here, the great and the good of the towns of Scotland here in the centre of the universe. Why are you laughing, Cliff, Professor? Of course, this is where I learn much about the towns of Scotland and how to rejuvenate them. Where I have to tell you, some of the most dedicated staff that I've ever worked with and gave me great ideas that I think have benefited me as minister over the last few years. And I'm also delighted that we're in Paisley, a town who twice this year has voted yes, as best I'm aware of, earlier this year, and to become a business improvement district. And I think that that's a very important sign for Paisley and will help give the foundations for the future, as we've heard from the council leader, and I'm sure we'll continue to hear about many reasons to be positive. And I think the slogan, the campaign, Proud Past, Positive Future, is very fitting for today's conference. Now, I launched the government's action plan on the 7th of November last year. Of course, that was a consequence of the National Review of Town Centres, which was an ambitious review and set us down a course of ambitious actions to ensure that the health of our town centres is at the very heart of the public sector decision-making and building stronger connections between the private, the public sector and the third sector as well. And I've impressed upon senior government officials and cabinet colleagues and other ministerial colleagues the importance of our town centres. And Lee's right, he did extract a promise from me last year in Inverness to publish a monitoring report, which I've done, and it helps focus the mind on what is still to be done going forward. But there's no doubt that that's given us food for thought and allows us to work together and share our experiences as we revitalise our town centres. And I am impressed across Scotland by the scale of activity taking place in the rejuvenation of our town centres, from people at a community level taking the lead in regeneration, from the businesses and the chambers of commerce and all the organisations that provide national and local support, the business improvement districts and our partners in local government, and with COSLA over the last year to focus on our towns. And one of the key asks from that external advisory group report was the adoption of the Town Centre First principle. That was agreed by the Scottish Government's Cabinet on the 24th of June and announced jointly with COSLA on the 9th of July. It was the main ask of the National Review. It calls on central government, local authorities, communities and the wider public sector to put town centres at the heart of and at the heart of proportionate and base value decision making, making the town centre a priority. Agreement to this principle marks a significant shift in public policy and is a further testament to the raised profile of the town centre agenda across all sectors. Stakeholder feedback suggests the adoption of the town centre first principle is legitimising a Scotland-wide discussion surrounding public decision-making in town centres. And the phrase itself is spreading as shorthand for what we talk about when we talk about improving the health of our town centres. I have a clear duty to ensure that the Scottish Government gets its own house in order in adopting and applying this principle and this policy. So as well as decisions that we will make, the much-read Scottish Public Finance Manual, which guides public bodies on the acquisition and the disposal of assets, has been revised and republished in October to adopt the Town Centre First principle when making decisions on property transactions, and so too the NH guidance will follow as well. A key change in Scottish planning policy through SPP was published in June, which reflected the principle and broadened out Town Centre First approach to a broader range of uses which attract a significant number of people who access their towns. At a practical level, a number of other authorities and local authorities have clearly demonstrated their commitment to town centres by acknowledging the principle and applying it when making investment decisions within their town centres. And I would like to name check some councils in particular, such as East Ayrshire, or Clackmannanshire, Falkirk, West Dumbartonshire, and East Renfrewshire, who can all showcase how they've implemented the principle in the decisions that they have taken in terms of locating public facilities and retaining them in town centres. Indeed, redirecting private sector investment into the heart of our town centres as well. But in celebrating the positives, RTPI is to be commended for Scotland's best places. And Carnegie UK Trust are also supporting us in understanding the interrelationships between towns and how to gauge progress. In terms of town centre living, crucial to the diversification of our town centres, we created the Town Centre Housing Fund, and it's showing through its demonstration projects how affordable housing can be created in town centre environments, transforming empty properties into town centre housing. Clear examples of this would include in Glengill Hall and Kirriemuir, where strong partnership working between Angus Council, a private developer, Historic Scotland and Scottish Government has regenerated an empty town centre building, providing 9 affordable homes for the local community. Yesterday, the Scottish Government hosted a one-day Scottish housing event, bringing together around 300 stakeholders to help shape a 5-year collaborative housing action plan for Scotland. And for the first time, I believe, town centres were a main issue in that consideration. And we look to see how we can mainstream housing policy with town centres in mind. Now, we're absolutely committed to supporting the right conditions for flourishing businesses and entrepreneurs across Scotland. And that's why we've retained the small business bonus, which is now at a record high with more than 96,000 properties benefiting. And that's an increase of 50% since we introduced the scheme back in 2008. Many thousands of business premises across Scotland's towns are seeing a real enduring benefit provided by the Small Business Bonus Scheme. We're also using the levers available to encourage long-term premises back into use. One such example would be the expansion of Fresh Start Rates Relief to apply to pubs, hotels and restaurants from April this year. Another example, legislative measure, would be through the Building Scotland Act to improve the cost recovery powers available to local authorities and enforcement actions to deal with dangerous and defective buildings, and this will come into force in January. We want to unlock the talents that exist in our communities and support them to achieve the outcomes that are important to them, because we know that when communities can do great things when they're empowered, they can achieve their own goals and great goals. I was proud to introduce the Community Empowerment Scotland Bill to Parliament this June, a bill that will provide the tools and break down barriers, empower communities to work in partnership with local service providers, including the public, private and third sector. Over 2014, I've witnessed a rise in the general public interest and awareness of local decision making and the community right to buy. This will no longer be the preserve of just rural communities, but can reach into urban areas and towns as well. Earlier this year, I launched the Stalled Spaces programme as one such avenue to stimulate use of local town centre land that had maybe become vacant or unused. Greening the space or allowing community access has made such a difference, and the Community Empowerment Bill will make more of these kind of initiatives. So too, the Community Empowerment Bill will provide a new power to local authorities to grant reliefs on non-domestic rates, another tool which might be used to promote town centres or create whatever local enterprise zone a local council feels is appropriate. Even now, our communities continue to be enterprising. In Fraserburgh, the Local Business Association and Local Development Trust combined their efforts to create Super Saturdays, and that was within the town centre, creating a sense of place and activity across retail, entertainment, leisure, and using public space in a way that you can interact and socialise, increasing the footfall in that particular community. The action plan reiterates the value of place-based decision-making and a longer-term outlook on the economic and social impacts of public sector investment decisions in our town centres. I've mentioned the public finance manuals that guide our decisions. We want to support more sustainable transport as well. That's why we've strengthened this in planning policy, and there's specific sustrans and other transport investment to support these particular actions, such as the Community Links programme. These will target gaps and deficiencies in local active travel networks. There's the greatest potential to increase walking and cycling for short journeys. And of the 187 partnership projects underway, a significant number are focused in and around our town centres. The Let's Get Walking Scotland strategy also supports smarter choices, smarter places, ensuring there's more support for sustainable travel choices. I attended a conference a few weeks ago and talked about the challenges of becoming smarter in our approach to economic development. Digital technology continues to impact on every aspect of our lives. The need to harness digital innovation in a way that can support and re-energise our town centres is absolutely vital. All of our town centres need access to next-generation broadband, and efforts will continue to push for broad coverage so that town centres don't get left behind. We have to deliver new ways of working to ensure that the digital revolution supports our town centres. So we're putting significant investment into digital infrastructure and supporting businesses to embrace the new technologies. And I'll put a particular focus in this forthcoming year into demonstrating digital projects to support businesses and entrepreneurs with new ideas going forward. We're more proactive in planning policy and have mentioned a number of proactive planning policy initiatives that will support our town centres. In addition to updating Scottish planning policy to reflect the town centre principle, I've announced over £100,000 towards a programme of town centre planning pilots in collaboration with 9 planning authorities, testing out ideas which will help simplify planning processes in town centre and help to encourage enterprise innovation and adaptation. We've also match-funded town centre charrettes across a number of local authority areas, and these will support communities in being engaged in the potential and capacity and the shaping of their town centres going forward. There's a tremendous number of organisations carrying out a range of activities when it comes to town centre regeneration. Many of them are represented here today. But collectively, these have the potential to be greater than the sum of their individual parts. And that's where we are happy to support Scotland's Town Partnership over the next 2 years to help them and enable them to be the go-to body for Scotland's town centres. STB is going to be instrumental in promoting and sharing all of the tools and learning being made available to town centre communities under the Action Plan. In doing so, they will help to embed the application of the Town Centre First principle in the consciousness of the public, private and community sectors. In a recent meeting, I know that senior civil servants enjoyed the exposure to and with the Scottish Towns Partnership, and I'm sure that this relationship will be fruitful going forward. I recently announced funding for the Scottish business and the community to trial a cluster approach to setting up business hubs in 4 areas, supported by a network of business connectors. I'm hugely interested to see how this work evolves with the wider support for businesses in an enterprising third sector landscape. It offers the potential to channel corporate resources into supporting not only the action plan, but a wider local economic development, social enterprise and entrepreneurial framework potential. I recently met with the chair and members of the external advisory group, and I appreciate that they have agreed to continue advising me on the future work of the town centre strategy and action plan. Their input has been invaluable. In terms of next year, I'd like to see further discussion going forward around improving alignment on the funding and support available to our town centre projects. This was raised at the cross-party group where there was a clear request for better alignment. I've continued to meet with community organisations and business improvement districts. I want to see more across Scotland. Steps are being taken by our national cultural and heritage bodies, such as Historic Scotland, Creative Scotland, Architecture and Design Scotland, to map the areas where their work intersects in a town centre. Indeed, I understand that they will look for towns in which they can demonstrate this potential. And related to the idea of alignment and investment, I'm also keen that further progress is made in linking community planning and the place agenda with spatial planning so that quality placemaking principles can be delivered. And I'll work with a local authority and CPP to achieve this. We'll also continue to support participatory budgeting, empowering local communities to make investment decisions that are right for them. So the Can-Do Towns Challenge, the Scottish Business and the Community Hubs model, increasing number of business improvement districts and the increasing number of enterprising development trusts, all of these point to the idea of town centres being at the heart of a renewed spirit of local innovation and enterprise. And this is also something I want to develop and build on. We have the foundations now for a collaborative, community-led economy in our town centres through the Town Centre Action Plan, and we can very much build on this. My final thoughts are that our town centre regeneration is a challenging but rewarding and worthwhile task. I look forward to hearing more from councils progressing the town centre first principle, from businesses and communities getting involved in the long-term visioning of their towns. I will continue to call on all public bodies to sign up to the principle and provide clear evidence on how it's making a practical difference in the town centres of Scotland. And in closing, I would also remind you of the role of Scotland's Towns Partnership and ask you that you use their services and engage with them to build up the evidence and experience that's going on. There is still much to be done, but I'm proud to look over the last year of what we've been able to achieve together in partnership. And I'm looking forward to what lies ahead for Scotland's town as we continue in partnership to rejuvenate the towns of Scotland. Thank you very much.